Alright, here's the deal with this fight. When we originally recorded this, because this is still on hard mode, I got my ass handed to me by this boss, because this boss is very hard. Even on normal mode, he's a little tough. I'm gonna say this guy's probably the hardest fight in the game. He is insane on extreme mode. The reason this is because, as you can see, he has a huge amount of health. A single Stinger missile doesn't do that much damage to him. And pretty much all of his attacks, except for maybe one or two, do a huge amount of damage to you. And several of his attacks have a really small window for dodging them. So I just re-recorded it because, when I first fought this, when Ironicus was here with me, it took me nearly 10, 11 minutes to beat him, which is a little long. So, but don't worry, I'm still posting that. It's just another video where my first run of this fight is. Here's one. This is probably his easiest dodge attack. Just get down the stairs, and his afterburners won't be able to get you, and then you can get a free shot on him. Two free shots if he wouldn't have activated his powers to go into cutscene mode and invalidate all of your missiles. There's this other attack here where he goes way away, and then he charges at you, and then you just dodge at the last second because he won't be able to change direction quick enough. Even on this run, I still get kind of messed up. Like here, this is the guy, this is his worst attack. It blows up the entire arena. I was trying to get to one of the safe spots over there, where that fire was near the door. That's a safe spot. And there's maybe one other spot that's safe, but pretty much the entire arena explodes and it's... If you don't have any rations equipped, it's an instant kill, basically. That's the worst attack on when you're fighting this guy on extreme. Oops. Especially because on extreme mode, there are only, I believe, two rations in the entire game. One for Snake and one for Raiden. You basically have to rely on having your health recharge when it gets really low, and also relying on the fact that your health gets completely refilled at certain points in the game, mostly after a boss fight and a couple other story events. Like after you beat, oh, and you can shoot Snake in the helicopter and they get angry and shoot at you. The one thing that makes this fight from being ridiculously hard is that Snake will all, at least on hard mode and lower, he won't do it on extreme. He will always throw you another ration, if you run out. He also throws you Stinger ammo, of course. Ugh. This is where I, like, got destroyed the first time, dodging these bullets here. Because sometimes he'll just angle around enough that he can nick you with, like, one or two bullets. And that's enough to send Ryan backflipping three times in the air, and then landing on his ass for 5 seconds before he gets back up.
I'll let you go out in style!
It's a fun fight, though. There, I just ran out of rations, so now Snake is gonna chuck one down at me. Of course, on the top floor, thanks, Snake.
What the?
Just trying to get one more hit in, but nope. And every once in a while, if you haven't been able to get a hit on the Harrier in a while, Snake will shoot it with his grenade launcher. It's better than nothing. Oh, and by the way, this is the last of the videos with live commentary. The rest is going to be post.
You all right?
Yeah. How about you guys?
Barely managed, but we're all right.
The chopper?
We need some time for repairs.
Oh.
The president's all yours.
Okay. Can I ask you something?
What?
Are you the Snake? They said you were dead.
No, not me. There are still too many things I need to do.
Snake, you're a legend, and that's why I need to ask you this.
Legend? A legend is nothing but fiction. Someone tells it. Someone else remembers. Everybody passes it on.
I'm here because I was assigned to this mission, not because I want to. If I could, I'd be out of here in a second. How could you come back to all this? Why keep fighting?
There's something my best friend said to me once.
What?
We're not tools of the government or anyone else. Fighting was the only thing I was good at, but at least I always fought for what I believed in.
What about the DNA results from that body?
That was Liquid's body. He and Snake are identical on the genetic level.
Liquid?
A deception, for our own protection. We stole his frozen body from some organization. Kind of a hassle, though.
That's all there is to it.
Are you two really an NGO?
Insofar as we're a non-profit organization of civilians advocating a cause, yes. The cause happens to be the eradication of Metal Gear.
We work on our own, but it's a cause worth fighting for.
Why would you stick your neck out for something this risky?
That's the way I used to look at it, 4 years ago. I was holed up in the middle of nowhere in Alaska, drinking too much.
We have a responsibility to the coming generations, to the world.
What responsibility?
To keep track of the mistakes we've made as a species.
We need to remember, to spread the word, to fight for change, and that's what keeps me alive.
You think you can change the future?
Nah, I'm not as arrogant as that.
What you do isn't grassroots activism. It's more like terrorism.
I admit that.
But our group, Philanthropy, received some information. A new Metal Gear prototype was being developed here, and terrorists were planning to raid the facility. The information came from a very reliable source.
So you're here to...
We're here to stop all that. But I also have a personal motive.
Looks like the terrorists have his sister in the big shell. We're here on our own, not under anyone's orders. We have our own battles. Otacon's here for someone. I'm not.
This is a military mission.
Jack, are you all right?
Just barely.
You almost gave me a heart attack.
Sorry, it wasn't intentional.
I know that, and I know I need to stay stronger.
Give it
Say
up,
a
Paul.
Prayer for me, Rose, so I can come back.
You will make it back. I'm with you all the way, remember?
That means a lot to me, you know.
I'm going to save the data, okay, Jack?
Colonel, Metal Gear's already gone active.
It's not too late. You can still prevent a nuclear strike by securing the president and preventing password confirmation from taking place. Get to the president. He's in the core section of Shell 2.
I'm checking the satellite images. Looks like you can get to the core from the other side of Strut L.
The core hasn't gone under yet from what we can tell. Follow the railings down, then jump onto the pipes.
The only viable strut in the outer perimeter is the L. That attack just now doesn't make any sense. It's like they have no more use for this place.
Colonel, you were monitoring the codec calls. That man was the real Snake all along.
Maybe.
Maybe?
Don't let your guard down with him.
Why do you say that?
Because they were never a part of the simulation. They're an unknown factor.
You can take your simulation and... We're out here. We bleed. We die.
Calm down.
I suggest that you do, Raiden. Even if that is Snake, that has no bearing on your mission.
Colonel, you and Snake used to be on the same side. I don't understand. I read about you and Snake in the Darkness of Shadow Moses.
I don't give a damn what that piece of trash said. Do you get me?
This actor is Hojo, too.
Oh, Colonel.
Do a sweet jump off that ramp.
Sure, I should do a sweet jump?
You should do a sweet jump off that ramp.
I'm gonna do a sweet jump off this ramp! Oh no!
Right, come in. Right.